my name is John Mark King, and this is my video presentation for my final project for CPSC 5185, Artificial Intelligence, under Dr. Khan. The reason for this video presentation is since most projects will be evaluated by Dr. Khan running them on his computer, this project cannot be run on a computer. This software is run on this thing.
Its name is Gumberly. It's Japanese for you can do it or go for it.
The idea behind the project originates from the mouse maze experiments used in psychology labs to measure the effect of a variable on learning, memory, or intelligence. The basic layout of these experiments is this. You place a mouse in a maze and measure the time it takes to get out. As this is repeated, the mouse begins to learn the maze, and the time required to traverse the maze decreases. The rate at which the mouse learns the maze can be used to infer to what effect the variable you are measuring has on the mouse's intelligence. For example, in this graph we have a plot of a series of lab maze experiments that was used to test the effect of the drug scopolamide hydrobromide. The layout of this project is the same. A mouse is placed in a maze and its performance is measured by the time it takes to escape the maze. As this is repeated, the mouse learns the maze and the time to escape should decrease. The only difference is that this mouse is a robot. And the variable being tested is a form of artificial intelligence called genetic algorithm.
It comes from a robot kit called Bobot by the company Parallax. Its brain has a 20 megahertz processor with 32 bytes of RAM and 2 kilobytes of memory. It navigates using a combination of infrared sensors looking to the left and right with a pair of whiskers that detects if it hits an obstacle.
As the robot traverses the maze, it sends an infrared signal to the left and to the right. As long as it gets a return on that signal, it knows to keep moving forward. However, if it no longer receives a return signal on either of its detectors, it knows there must be a turn available and in which direction. At this point, it stops to get instruction from the genetic algorithm as signaled by 2 high-pitched beeps.
In this video, we are going to hear some sounds that makes it goes beep beep. And then, if it gets it wrong, it goes like,
If Gumberly receives a command that it knows it cannot execute, such as to take a right turn when it knows that no right turn exists, then it will reject that command and ask for a new one. When it does this, it gives 2 lower pitched beeps.
If Gumberly encounters an obstacle, his whiskers will detect and Gumberly will back up and get instruction from the genetic algorithm.
If Gumberly manages to escape the maze, it can detect this through its infrared sensors. And once it makes this determination, it does a little victory dance, and then a little taunting. There is a limiting factor in testing due to the battery life of the robot, which was limited to about 2 hours. In 2 hours, it was possible to run about 6 generations. A graph of results shows a definite downward trend in times both in optimal and average times per generation, which seem to indicate that the algorithm was working. In generation 6, there is a time of 1 minute and 34 seconds, which is only about 5 to 10 seconds from an optimal time. So although an optimal solution was not found, we came very close.
Things up.